15 recordings. Ang laki.
Hello, student. Today we are going to study about the Mughal Empire. So, page 45. So, student, today we are going to study about the Mughal Empire. So, there was three parts in the Mughal Empire, okay? So, the first part is the Mughal ruler number one, and the Mughal ruler number two, and the last is Mughal architecture and literature. So, now first we will study about the Mughal ruler number one. So, just note down Mughal ruler number one.
We use history, geography, and civics.
Civics. Chapter 4, the Mughal Empire. Do you see, student? So, student, can I start?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So, student, in the Mughal Empire, there was three parts, okay? The first part is the Mughal ruler number one, and the second part is the Mughal ruler number two, and the third part is the Mughal architecture and literature. So just note down Mughal ruler number one. So in the first point is the Babur, and the second point is the Humayun. Babur's son name is the Humayun, and the third point is Sher Shah Suri, okay? So first we'll study about the Babur. So if student, can I start? So student first,
yes, point,
okay. So student first point, we'll start about Babur, okay. So Babur was the founder of the Mughal Empire. He defeated Ibrahim Lodi in the first battle of Panipat in 1526, and Babur brought gunpowder to India, okay. And in 1527, he fought battles of Kanwa, and he defeated Rana Sanga in the Mewar. And he wrote his own autobiography, that is Tuzuk-i-Babri. So I will spell the Tuzuk-i-Babri, okay? Tuzuk-i-Babri. Babur died at Agra in 1530 AD, and his tomb is at Kabul. So student, if the question comes, who was the founder of the Mughal Empire? The answer is Babur. And who defeated Ibrahim Lodi in first battle of Panipat in 1526? The answer is Babur. Who brought gunpowder to India? The answer is Babur. And in 1527, who fought battle of Kanwa and defeated Rana Sanga in Mewar? The answer is that also Babur. So now we will move to the second part, that is Humayun, Babur's son. So Humayun was the second ruler of Mughal dynasty. His biography was written by his sister, name is Hulakta Begum, and the book name was Humayun. Humayun fought two important battles, that is, number one is Battle of Chausa in 1539 and Battle of Kanut in 1540. So student, if the question comes, who was the second ruler of Mughal dynasty? The answer is Humayun. Whose biography was written by his sister? The answer is Humayun. And the sister name was Gulabta Begum. And if the question comes, who fought two important battles? The answer is Humayun fought two important battles, that is Battle of Tausa in 1539, Battle of Canudos in 1540. Okay, so now we'll move to the third point, Sersar Suri. So Sersar Suri ruled in 1540 to 1555. So who defeated Sersar Suri defeated Humayun. Okay, and Sersar Suri was known for his administrative changes. Sersar Suri introduced silver coins, that is known as rupaya. Sersar Suri fixed standard weights and measurement. Sersar Suri built GT road. Full form of GT is Gun Trunk Road from Kolkata to Peshawar. Sersar Suri was buried in Sasaram, currently in Bihar. Sersar Suri built Purana Qila in Delhi. So, student, if I am very fast, just tell me, okay? So I will stop and do slowly. So till now, do you understand what I'm explaining?
Yes, miss.
Okay, so if the question, just note down, because I just make little point that is important. So if the question come, who was there?
Miss.
Yes?
Miss, text are we?
Yes, what? So, sorry again, just tell me, what are you saying?
Which sticks are we using?
Sources and our past two. Do you see page number 45, the Mughal Empire?
History.
Yes, history.
Yes, please.
Okay. So I'm not. The lesson I'm just going through all. So I'm just taking out the important points, so I'm explaining to you. Okay? So if you have any doubt, just tell to me, okay? So can I explain again?
Yes, miss.
Okay, so student, if the question comes, who defeated Humayun, the answer is Sersar Suri, okay? So Sersar Suri ruled in 1542-1555. And if the question comes, who was known for his administrative changes, the answer also Sersar Suri. And who introduced silver coins, rupaya, the answer is Sersar Suri, okay? And if the question comes, who built GT Road, Grand Trunk Road, from Kolkata to Peshawar? The answer is Sersar Suri. And the last we will see from the Mughal ruler number one, that is Muhammad Adil Shah, the last Suri ruler. Okay, so the dynasty was finished in 1555. So student, today, do you understand till now what I explained to you, the Mughal ruler number one? Student, I'm asking to you, do you understand the Mughal ruler number one?
Yes, miss.
Yes. Okay, student, now can I move to the second part, Mughal ruler number two? So in the second Mughal ruler number two, we can see number one is the Akbar. And in 1560, Akbar turned to 18 and he fought many important battles. The first one is the second battle of Panipat. Akbar defeated Hemu in 1556, and the battles of Haldikot Haldighati, Akbar defeated Maharana Pratap in 1576. Akbar built city Fatehpur Sikri and shifted his court there. Akbar formed a new religion, name is Din-e-Ilahi. Akbar abolished Jasya tax, and Akbar has 9 jewel, that is Navratna. We'll just see the 4 points. Number 1 is Abul Faizi, Akbar Namba, his biography. Number 2 is Faizi, Raj Kavi Lilavati. Number 3 is Birbal, Kavi Priya. Number 4 is Todarmal, that is revenue system. And the second point we will see from the Mughal ruler number 2, that is Jahangir. Jahangir name is Salim or Saiko Baba. Jahangir married Nur Jahan. Nur Jahan name is Mer ul Nisa. The spelling is Meher-ul-Nisa. Jahangir wrote his own biography, that is Tuzuk-e-Jahangiri. The spelling is Tuzuk-e-Jahangiri. So, student, just turn the page number, page number 48. So here we will see the Babur in 1526. From there, you can, from page number 48 to page number 49, you just have to go through the whole chapter and just read out the important points. I already note down what is the important points, but still just read out all the important points, because if I conduct, I can conduct from this MCQ or in the main exam as well. Okay, so in Jahangir time, there came two English, that is Captain William Hawkins, and the second point is Sir Thomas Roy. So Captain William Hawkins represent East India Company, Sir Thomas Roy represent James Wands. Jahangir times painting with its Jenny during his reigns. And the third point we will see Shah Jahan. So Shah Jahan time, golden days of Mughal Empire. His last days were painful, imprisoned in Agra Fort by his own Aurangzeb. So in Shah Jahan time, there two French travelers were came, that is one is Bernier and the second one is Trevenier. So the spelling Bernier is B-E-R-N-I-E-R. And the second point is
excuse me, miss.
Yes, yes.
Are you reading the text?
No, I'm not reading the text. I'm reading all the text, and I just take out the few pills of important points, and I'm telling you.
I think it is not same with the text, that's right.
Okay. No, what I'm saying is, like, I already read out the full text, okay, the chapter, this chapter. So I'm just taking out the important points. So,
I'm searching for what I'm reading. That's
sorry, I cannot hear you. What? Hello? So can I continue again explaining?
Yes, please.
Okay. So Sahajan times, Sahajan golden days of Mughal Empire. His last days were painful, imprisoned in Agra Fort by his own son Aurangzeb. And Sahajan's time, there two friends came, travelers, that is Bernier and Trevenier. The spelling of Berner is B-E-R-N-I-E-R, and the second one is T-R-A-V-E-R-N-I-R. So student, I know that what you are saying is correct, chapter for the Mughal Empire, but I just read out all the chapters and I take out the important points. So what I'm saying is the important points what I make is it will be easy for you to understand the full chapters. You don't have to go through all the full chapters. I'm just taking out the important points so that you can get the more ideas. If you want to go through, you can go through, but I'm just take out the important points I'm giving to you. Okay, student. So student, can I continue explaining?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, So the fourth point is from the Mughal Empire to now we'll almost cover the last point, that is Aurangzeb and the later Mughals. First we will see the Aurangzeb. So Aurangzeb imprisoned his own father and kept her the throne. So Aurangzeb have a title, name is Alamgir. So Aurangzeb intolerant to what other religions. So earlier what we see, Akbar motivate other religions, okay? But Aurangzeb intolerant to what other religions. He want more to come he want more peoples to convert to Islam, okay? So earlier what we see, Akbar abolish Jizya tax, okay? But Aurangzeb reintroduced Jizya tax. And Akbar asked 9 Guru, that is Guru Tegh Bahadur, to embrace Islam on refusing, and he assassinated him, okay? So till now, do you understand what I'm explaining to them? Okay, I will just tell you the important points. So if the question comes, who imprisoned his own father and captured the throne? The answer is Aurangzeb. And who intolerant to what other religion? The answer also is Aurangzeb. And who reintroduced Jizya tax? That is Aurangzeb. And who abolished Jizya tax? That is, the answer is Akbar, okay? So now we will move to the last, that is Aurangzeb and later Mughals. We already covered the Aurangzeb. Now we will move to the later Mughals. So in the later Mughals, in 1707 to 1857, there is only 3 points. That is Bahadur Shah I, and the middle, and the second one is Muhammad Shah, and the third one is Bahadur Shah II. So in the second, in the second point, Muhammad Shah, given by Nadir Shah, invaded Peacock throne and Kohinoor diamond was taken away. So student, till now, do you understand what I'm explaining to you? Okay, so now we will move to the last part. First, what we study? We study about the Mughal Empire. So there was 3 parts, okay? The first part is the Mughal ruler number 1, and the second part is the Mughal ruler number 2, and the third part is the Mughal architecture and literature. So first we will see the Mughal architecture. So number 1 is Babur. Babur built 2 mosques in Panipat and Sambalpur. And the second one is Humayun. Babur's son name is Humayun. Humayun built Jamali mosques. And the third one is Akbar. Akbar built Agra Fort, and Akbar built Fatehpur Sikri. If the question comes, who built Fatehpur Sikri? The answer is Akbar. In Fatehpur Sikri, there is 4 points. Number one is Diwan-e-Am, and number two, and the second one is Diwan-e-Khas, and the third one is Salim Sisti Tomb, and the third is Bulan Darwaza, and the fourth is Jodhpai Palace. So what we see in Mughal architecture, we will see all the main points. Okay, first we'll see Babur. Babur built two mosques that in Panipat and Sambalpur, and the second one is Humayun built Jamali mosque, and the third is Akbar built Agra Fort, and the fourth is Jahangir built Moti Masjid in Lahore. So student, there is three Moti Masjid. First we see Jahangir built Moti Masjid in Lahore, and the fifth point is Shah Jahan built Taj Mahal in Agra, and Moti Masjid Shah Jahan built Red Fort and Jama Masjid in Delhi. And the sixth point is Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb built Bibi Ka Maqbara in Aurangzeb. And he also built Moti Masjid in Delhi. And the last we will see Mughal literature. So till now, do you understand, student, what I'm explaining to you?
Yes, please.
Okay. So the last is we will study Mughal literature. Number one is Babur. Babur wrote Tuzuk-e-Babri, that is Babur Nama. And the second point is Jahangir wrote Tuzuk-e-Jahangiri. And the second point we will see about the biographies. Humayun's sister wrote the book that is Humayun Nama, and the Humayun's sister name was Gupta Begum. And the second point is Akbar Nama wrote Abdul Faisal, and the third point is Akbar period. In the Akbar period, we see Faizi, that is Lilavati. And second point is Tulsi Das, Rama Charita Manas. In the book literature, in the last part of the book literature, we see the book was translated in Persian, that is Mahabharata, and Ramayana was translated by Badaun. The spelling is Badaun, or B-A-D-A-U-N. Gita and Upanishad was translated by Dara Sikor. The spelling of Dara Sikor is D-A-R-A-S-H-I-K-O-H. So, till here, we finish the Mughal Empire. So, if you have any question, just ask me and I will clarify to you. Yes. So student, please turn to the page number 46. Do you see that who were the Mughal Empire?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so I will just read out and please underline, okay, the important points. Okay, who were the Mughals? The Mughals were descendants of two great lineages of rulers from their mother's side. They were descendants of Genghis Khan, died 1227, the Mongol ruler who ruled over part of China and Central Asia. From their father's side, they were the successor of Timur. So till here, you just underline. And after that, just underline, this was because Genghis Khan's memory was associated with the massacre of innumerable people. It was also linked with the Uzbek, their Mongol competitor. On the other hand, the Mughals were proud of their Timurid ancestry, not least of all because their great ancestor had captured Delhi in 1398. So just underline where I'm leading. After that, just go to
page.
Yes? Page number 47. I'm reading page number 46 to 47. Do you want me to read all again?
Yes, miss.
Okay. The Mughal, just page number 46. Who were the Mughal? Just underline. The Mughal were descendant of two great lineages of ruler from their mother's side. They were descendant of Genghis Khan, died 1227, the Mongol ruler who ruled over part of China and Central Asia. From their father's side, they were the successor of Timur, the ruler of Iran, Iraq, and modern day Turkey. Till Turkey underline, and after that, just underline, this was because Genghis Khan memory was associated with the massacre of innumerable people. It was also linked with the Uzbek, their Mongol competitor. On the other hand, the Mongols were proud of their Timurid ancestry, not least of all because their great ancestor had captured Delhi in 1398.
Thank you.
Okay. So this is the important points. Okay, so student. So student, please just go through all the chapters. And if you have any doubt, just tell me again. And please, student, just turn the page number 57. Do you see the math, the following?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
So just read out and just do math the following. Fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks and try to solve question number 10 and 11. Okay. Just read out all the chapter. If you have any doubt, just tell me. And please try to do your home assignment is match the following. Turn page number 57, 58, fill in the blanks, and 59, question number 10 and 11. Try to solve this question, the important question, 10 and 11. So till now, till here we finish our first chapter, that is the Mughal Empire. So if you have any doubt, do you understand what I'm explaining to you?
Yes, miss.
Okay.
Yes, miss.
Okay, thank you. Student.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, hope.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.
Ports.
Ports.
Miss, bye.
Bye.